my fellow Americans, as well as our neighbors in Canada and Mexico, to our friends in Colombia, Ecuador, and all of Central and South America, also to those high pingers overseas, in Europe, France, and Poland, in the mountains of Portugal, the rolling hills of England and Scotland, and the rest of the United Kingdom, also to those halfway across the earth, to our sister country Australia, China, and who can forget New Zealand, and countless others all over the globe. I come to you today in the most dire of circumstances, for it is today that we mourn the passing of what was once a great and noble video game, and considered by many as simply the greatest video game ever made. I am talking, of course, about the GOAT, which is Halo Combat Evolved. Halo Combat Evolved changed the gaming world forever, introducing three generations to a whole new gaming experience we like to call LAN, or Local Area Network. From boomers to Gen X and millennials, no other video game in the history of video games has brought more people together like Halo Combat Evolved. It all started with what would be one of the most glorious campaign experiences of all time. It was during the initial Xbox launch that people discovered Halo Combat Evolved. Many first generation consoles came with Halo Combat Evolved, which was already touted as the year's best game by IGN, GameStop, and many of the world's leading gaming voices. And while the campaign was truly a masterpiece, with difficulties ranging from easy to normal to heroic and even legendary, it was the multiplayer mode that spawned a love for the game, which has endured all these 1 in 20 years. But it would not end at just the split-screen, four-person multiplayer. No, it would not. Split-screen was just the beginning. Local LAN brought an entirely new era to gaming. Now, instead of being forced to play on the same screen as your screen-watching big brother, or your dad, or your cousins, or even your besties, you were enabled to connect another TV and another Xbox and play on a completely different console and system, even in another room if you so chose. We went from being able to just play with up to four players on a single console to being able to play with up to eight players with a single, simple Cat5 crossover cable. And then we discovered we could even connect multiple Xboxes via a hub or a router, enabling us to play up to 16-player multiplayer games. This was truly mind-blowing and, at the time, an absolute game-changer. The local LAN scene started to explode in every major city across America, and in every small town and podunk village, penetrating even the darkest corners of our great country, like trailer parks and ghettos. The evolution of gaming was inevitable at this point, with all of America completely engaged and enthralled in the Halo 1 community. With local LAN scenes came local tournaments, with some gamers claiming wins in over 50 local LAN tournaments in their legendary careers, and allegedly winning sponsorships from companies like Pepsi and Cox Communications, Cheetos and Red Bull, and even Pizza Hut and Mountain Dew. In fact, plumbers and electricians from all over the country came together to support these great events. With local tournaments came regional and eventually national tournaments, with my good friend and Halo soulmate, Darkman the GOAT, winning the first ever Halo Combat Evolved National Championship, paving the way for players like the Ogres, Walshy, T-Squared, and others, signing the world's first professional video gaming contracts in the sum of $125,000 over 3 years. And that was life-changing money for those players. Inevitably, the national Halo Combat Evolved gaming scene exploded, with companies like iGames, Halo 50K, AGP, and finally MLG, or Major League Gaming, paving the way for the future of professional gaming. Unfortunately, we don't have time today to do a deep dive into the glorious history of Halo Combat Evolved professional gaming. Instead, I'd like to discuss the current state of affairs of Halo Combat Evolved and the Master Chief Collection gaming community in general. And today, after over 21 glorious years of Halo, Combat Evolved, the game itself stands but on the edge of a cliff. But not just any cliff, nay, a vast canyon. The Valles Marineris of the gaming world, where it could very easily slip into the abyss, doomed for all ages, with just the slightest push. A butterfly landing on the shoulder of a giant could send this game toppling over the edge, drowning in the mid-ocean rift along the Mariana Trench of the gaming world of the Challenger Deep. But alas, I do not come to you today with a message of despair, depravity, and doom, but with a message of hope. Hope for our people, peace for our gaming nations, and prosperity for the game we all love so much and have dedicated so much of our lives to. Today, my message is twofold. I speak to the community as a whole, but I address the factions within the community individually. First, to the friendlies. You are my people. To the noobs, to the bots, the mere mortals, the bottom feeders, the gray tiers, you are my people. We must rise up and stand in solidarity against the oppression of the toxic players, the trolls, the cheaters, the hackers, and the stream snipers in this community. While their voices may be the loudest, they are the few and we are the many. We outnumber them 100-1. I was briefly able to infiltrate their community. I sat with them, drank with them, dined on the Anubis flesh with them, humped and teabagged the dead corpses of mine enemies, and learned their ways. I did all of this for the good of the community. I did all of this for my people. We must stand together against the tyranny of their oppression. We must four-stack in socials and encourage others to do the same, in hopes that they won't be able to run through the playlist with wanton aggression. There will be casualties, oh yes, there will be casualties. We may lose the Tonic Polecats and the Hawaiian 7813s of the world, but that's a sacrifice I'm willing to make for the betterment of our great community, this small yet iconic society which we've created. I also wish to address the other side of the aisle, the toxic members of this community, who wish nothing more than to see Halo, Combat Evolved, and the world burn. You have done your damage. It's time to move on. And to the trolls, stop stoking the fire just to get a reaction. The weak-minded and lowly skilled cannot handle your constant agitations to their delicate psyche. You are the superior human beings, the smartest of us, the best of us. We all know that, and we choose to give you the respect that you have demanded. To the toxic individuals, quit humping and teabagging dead corpses, sticking and smacking their bodies in an act of defiance, disrespect, and self-indulgence. We know you are better than us. You don't have to rub it in. Our delicate nature leads us towards rainbows and unicorns, not bloodshed and violence. Please let us be with our happy ARs and our overzealous frag grenades. It's all we've got. Also, to the hacker, you can suck it. And finally, to the stream snipers, you're all killing the game. You have single-handedly erased many well-intentioned streamers simply by your relentless stream sniping in pursuit of your ultimate goal to get a better game. Countless streamers have been victim to your crimes, your shenanigans, and it has to stop. Try to become decent human beings and let people have their own lives. Their stream is not about you, it's about them. Stop making it about you. Quit being such a tool. If you queue up against a known streamer, win the game and then give them a break. Don't relentlessly pursue that streamer over and over and over again for your own glory. You're not bathing yourself in glory, you're bathing yourself in the blood of your enemies. And I can assure you that's not a good look. Since you seem to think that you are so great at Halo, Combat Evolved, start streaming yourself and show the world how Halo, Combat Evolved should be played. Instead of making average or above average players, or slightly below average players, look worse and making them more miserable, forcing them to end their streaming careers prematurely. And finally, I want to speak to who is ultimately directly responsible for the misgivings of Halo, Combat Evolved, and Halo, the Master Chief Collection. Specifically, that's Microsoft's own 343 Industries. Never in the history of video games, and probably in modern history in general, has any company or group of individuals been given so much responsibility, so much freedom, and so little oversight to take what is essentially a masterpiece, a modern opus of a gaming trilogy, and historically and unequivocally destroyed such a sacred thing. I liken it to the modern-day versions of the Bible, written and rewritten, interpreted, reinterpreted, and misinterpreted to the point where it's nearly unrecognizable, a mere shadow of its former greatness and glory. The tragedy of Halo Combat Evolved starts as a console game, which was then ported to a PC game, which was then ported back to a console game, which was then ported back to a PC game. So you see the irony there. Perhaps tragically and ironically, there are simple fixes to these issues, which 343 cannot seem to grip or master. For every step forward 343 takes, they've taken a hop, skip, and a jump backwards, grinding this once great game into the shell of its former self that we see today. For every Ghost Rocket, Phantom Snipe, poor pistol bullet registration, and nade apparition that you continue to ignore, there's an equal force of moronic additions to the game, weapon and vehicle skins that degrade the game's integrity, post-game poses that act as ego boosts for millennials seeking participation trophies, and XP rewards that gratify few as the brokenness of the game persists. In fact, a single cheater hacker who unabashedly flaunts his abilities, flying around the maps with infinite ammo and high-speed bullets while constantly typing racist and hateful comments in the game chat and right on stream in the public eye, laughing in the faces of 343, who either cannot or will not do anything to stop the madness, regardless of the constant daily reports coming in. However, there is one very simple thing that can be done by 343 Industries that would go a long way towards alleviating some of the pain of the Halo Combat Evolved community. There is a giant gulf of a skill gap between the ranked, hardcore doubles players and the players who choose to spend their time in the social playlist, meanwhile leaving stronger players who prefer not to play twos with no real competitive constructive outlet. The Halo Combat Evolved community desperately needs a ranked 4v4 playlist, which would take little to no effort on 343's behalf. I genuinely believe that a ranked, rotating Halo Combat Evolved playlist in the 4v4 category would alleviate much of this tension. It would give the competitive players an outlet while allowing the social players to continue with their ways in the social playlist. And I want to leave you today with this one last thought. May Halo Combat Evolved live forever, and may Halo 1 never die. Thank you, and good night.